Do you want to make a lightsaber? Of course you do. It's not hard, and it looks cool. Two great reasons. So today we're going to show you how to accomplish this great looking not hard effect inside of After Effects. And of course you do have some plugins like Video Copilot Saber that will help pull this off, but today we're going to take a look at a version that needs no third-party plugins at all. Before we jump into After Effects, the first thing I want to point out is the practical lighting within our shot. You can do this sort of light coming off the lightsaber in post, but real lighting in a real environment actually on your talent will always be infinitely better. Like the effect itself, I wanted to stay very simple here, so we got a wooden dowel. You could use anything, of course, and we wrap this in battery-powered LED lights. Then we just set it to the color we want our lightsaber to be, and we're good to go. With our footage shot and inside of After Effects, we're going to create a new solid by going up to Layer, New, and tap Solid. We'll call this Saber, and we can keep the color white for now since we'll be changing that later on anyway. Now click OK and you're ready to start masking. So we'll grab our pen tool by clicking here or pressing G on the keyboard. Now you're going to hide your solid layer by clicking this eyeball on the left-hand side, and with the solid selected, create a mask that follows the lightsaber throughout the shot. If you want to round out any of the edges, click to create a point, and while holding, move your cursor to round that out. Now you're going to open your tracker window and track your mask. This will probably result in some errors depending on your shot, so just go through and correct them as you go. You can, of course, do this manually as well, and if you do want to do it manually, we're going to open our saber layer here, go to mask, and click the stopwatch next to mask path. And now go throughout your entire clip and mask out your lightsaber. And we are just very closely following the stick here, covering it all up to fully conceal this behind our solid. A good tip to speed this process up, which does depend on how this moves. If it's spinning around, this isn't really going to be helpful for you. But if it's a small movement like this, instead of going frame by frame, you can jump to the end of the move, adjust your points, then work backward, adjusting your mask in between frames. And even if you do have a lot of movement, you could do the same thing by sectioning out your movements that do connect. But once you're done masking, it's time to create the actual saber effect. So duplicate your saber layer a few times, and while having all the saber layers selected, hit F on your keyboard to reveal the mask feather. For the bottom layer, keep the mask feathering pretty low, something around 5 pixels should be good. For the next one, change that to about 30 pixels, then 60, 90, 120, and finally 240 pixels. Of course, you could do variations of this, just go with whatever looks best to you. But this will give your saber a nice glow. So now select all the saber layers, right click, and tap pre-comp, and we'll call this saber comp. Inside of our comp, we're gonna create a black solid and place it underneath everything. This is key to give our saber its color. Then back in our main comp, we're gonna change the saber comp blending mode to screen, and with the saber comp selected, go to Effect, Color Correction, and tap Color Balance. In Effects Controls, tap Preserve Luminosity, and here is where you can get as creative as you would like with the color. I like to start with the highlights, then work my way back, and you can keep the color subtle or make it more saturated, whatever is best for the tone that you're going for. Finally, you can drop on a levels effect, make slight adjustments, then turn on motion blur for your saber layers inside the pre-comp, and with that, you now have your lightsaber effect. You can push this a little further if you would like by going to Effects, Distort, and tapping Turbulent Displace. Turbulent Displacement! Turbulent Displacement! This will give your saber some warping to represent the heat the saber is outputting. I like to keep this subtle, so I'll lower the amount down to about 5. Then while holding Alt on Windows or Option on a Mac, you can click the Evolution Stopwatch, which will open this expression box. Now we're gonna type wiggle, open bracket, 6, comma, 50, close bracket. This will give it that warping movement. And you can change those numbers to get the look that you're after. The first number stands for frequency, which is how often you want the evolution value to move per second, and the second number stands for amplitude, which is how much you want your value to change above or below the starting value. So in this example, the evolution moves 6 times every second and will only move from minus 50 to 50. If you did not shoot with practical light like we did and you want some light interacting with your subject, you can create an adjustment layer and mask and feather the areas that you want the light to spill onto, then drop on a curves effect and play with the color channels. But again, adding the light in the actual scene is easy and infinitely better, so, you know, do that. But that's it for today. If you have something you would like to see us cover in the future, drop us a comment below. And don't forget to like and subscribe, because cows have best friends and get stressed when separated.